Hello, how are you today?
Hello, good evening.
How are you doing? Nice to see you. Let me make the light.
Good evening.
Good evening, how are you?
Fine.
Good evening, teacher.
Hi, how are you? How was your week? Your weekend? Did you have a nice weekend?
Very nice, teacher.
Estoy en oscuro. Pues sí, hágase la luz. Ok, vamos a ver quiénes ya están por acá. Fifteen. Vamos a ver aquí. Se me pierde crímenes. Okay, there we go. Tell me present, please. Ana Alicia. Ángel.
Present.
Benjamín. Carlos Ernesto.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Carolina.
Present, teacher.
Daniela. David Alexander.
Present, teacher.
Nice. Edwin.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Grace Mitchell. Grace, Maria de la Paz.
Presente, teacher, presente.
Pues sabía yo que por ahí está. Isabel. Isabel, no here.
Present.
Okay, ahí está, muy bien. Jonathan Alex.
Hola, teacher, presente.
Juan Antonio. Karen Janet.
Present.
Marina Vanessa.
Presente, teacher.
Marlene Elizabeth. Marlene.
Present, teacher. Present, teacher.
Muy bien. Rosailda.
Present, teacher.
Sí. Teresa de Jesús.
Present, teacher.
Walter Orlando. Walter. Yuri. Yuri.
En el chat le escribió de que va de camino, según entiendo.
Are students?
Present, teacher.
Brenda Jamile. Brenda. Luis Mauricio.
Present, teacher.
Teresa del Carmen. Teresa. Yancy Catalina.
Present, teacher.
Yancy, nice. Ahí estamos, batch. Analicia here. No. Benjamin. Daniela. Grace Michelle. Juan Antonio. Walter. Judy. Teresa del Carmen. Teresa, no, Teresa. Okay, bueno, this is...
Teacher, me present, Grace.
Sí, ya la llamé dos veces. Dos veces, ¿dónde estaba escondida?
No, no había ingresado a la clase, lo siento, hasta ahorita.
Ah, vaya, vaya. Ya la vimos. Grace. Ok. Pacha. Okay, well, let's begin your school story. Y aquí tengo mi lámpara mágica. Okay, well, I'm going to share.
Good evening, teacher.
How are you?
Estoy llegando a casa y en un ratito enciendo la cámara, teacher.
Ok, perfecto, perfecto. Vale, a ver. We're going to make a brief discussion about what is personal and what is personal. Do you remember? What's personal and what is personal?
Uh-huh. Me, teacher.
Yes, tell me.
Personal means that belongs to a particular person. And personal means people who work for any company or anything.
Exactly. Personnel is the staff, right? All the group of people who live or who work in a company, and personal is something mine, right? My belonging. Can you give me an example, please? Mm-hmm. Can you give me an example?
Staff de inglés corporativo.
Yeah, I'm going to write it here. Let's see. This what? Bash, I'm ready to write your sentence. Okay, let's see. This. This company, we can say, right? Uh-huh. This company, what? Mm-hmm. This company, yeah,
stuff.
This company.
The stuff.
This company staff. Pero pongámoslo en una oración completa. This company has a lot of personnel. ¿Ya? Porque la palabra que vamos a utilizar es personnel. That is called the staff, right? Okay, this company has a lot of personnel. Tell me.
Or you can say, this company is training her, o no sé, su personal, her personal.
Company is training its personal. Vamos a usar it como possession porque company is it. Okay. It's personal. Ay, mire qué bonita la teacher lo que escribió. It's personal. Ahí está. Muy bien. This company is training its personnel. Can you give me another example using personnel?
My company needs new personnel.
Okay. My company needs personnel. Mm-hmm. Great.
New personnel or more personnel?
Needs more personnel. Personnel. Ahí sería personnel. Este. ¿Verdad? Porque estamos hablando de como empleados. More staff. Can you use personal in a sentence? Personal. Por ejemplo, en el aeropuerto siempre le dicen, do not leave your personal belongings and unattended.
Yeah. Can you say, excuse me, can you say the personnel of the company will have his Christmas party or Christmas celebration?
Sure, sure. The personnel of the, ay, espérenme, ¿quién le agarró esto? The personnel of the personnel. Right? The personnel of the company will have its Christmas celebration or party. Yeah, sure. Nice. Okay, now you see the difference between personal and personnel, right? Okay, now let's talk about, this is just a quick review because we already did this. And we're going to concentrate in some other topics today. Check. Just let's make the matching quickly. What is banks? What is the industry for banks?
The financial industry. Letter E, the finance industry.
Okay. Banks are in the business industry.
Finance or finance. Oh, finance industry.
Yeah, in the finance,
industry.
Great. What about soft drinks? Soft drinks.
The beverage industry.
Okay. The soft drinks are on the beverage industry. Guided tours.
The tourism industry.
Tourism industry. What about cardboard boxes?
The packaging industry.
Industry.
Okay, and the packages.
Little G.
Packaging. That's on the packaging industry. What about buildings?
The construction industry.
That's the construction industry. Mobile phones.
The telecommunication industry.
Yes. Okay. Medicine.
The pharmaceutical industry.
Pharmaceutical industry. Yeah. Car components. Car components.
The automobile industry.
The automobile. Automotive. Right?
Automobile.
Okay, hairstyle services.
The beauty and personal care industry.
And the last one, clothes.
The textile industry.
That's the textile industry. Nice. Very good. Very good. Okay. Well, that was, as I said, just being a review of what we have been talking about during this unit, because this is to close unit number 2. Now, remember we were also talking about the past, right? And we said that when we are making sentences in the past, if we are using the regular verbs, we have to put ed to the verb or just d if it finishes with e, when talking about regular verbs in the past, right? Affirmative, regular verbs. And when you describe the simple past and they are using a regular verb, it says the simple past describes past events. Use the verb in the ed form, right? That's the form we are going to use for positive sentences. But for negatives, we use didn't plus the base form of the verb. And then you have didn't attend, didn't exchange. I didn't go to the party. I didn't play soccer. Yes. And here they are presenting to you the regular ones because are the ones that where you have to follow a rule, right? You know, in the irregular ones, you just have to take your list and pay attention to what is the past simple and what is the past participle, right? Okay, what about here? Let's see. Did you enjoy the seminar? Did I put the auxiliary, right? In the yes, no question, I use the auxiliary did, and then I use the verb, well, the subject, followed by the verb in the base form, yeah? So to make my question, my yes, no question, I have auxiliary, subject, and the verb in the base form. Did you enjoy? Did you make? Did Janet update? And something good about the simple past is that you don't have to worry that you're saying he, she, it, we, you, they, because the form of the verb will always be the same, right? In affirmative, in negative, and in question, okay? So you don't have to worry about the form of the verb in this case. Any question over there? Question, no question. No question?
No, teacher.
Nice, nice. Let's complete the sentences then. Did you attend to a seminar last month? What about the next question? How would you complete the next one? Did you
enjoy
the seminar?
Okay, did you enjoy the seminar? Did you enjoy? I'm going to go to the manual later. Because it's difficult to find here. We are in the manual, we are on page 24, okay? Page 24. I'm going to take you. Okay, page 24 in your manual.
Teacher, I have a question. Exactly the sentences, but in the plataforma, we have an exercise like this.
Le escuché como un poco cortado, Ana.
The homework, we have an exercise like this. For me was a little bit difficult. Well, I didn't found the correct answer for exam for exercise number two. In a
which exercise? Can you tell me the number of exercise?
Number two, it was exactly the same exercise as you already show us in the screen. Was the exercise number two?
Yeah, but which exercise? Remember that they go with number. Which video conference?
When we made questions, the auxiliary. Or two.
Number seven. Assignment number seven.
I think.
Can you check?
I am going to show you in a few moments.
Okay. What was the problem there? What was your problem in the exercise? Vaya, let's see. While Anna looks for the exercise, let's check here. Remember one thing, I guess it's number seven, right, Anna? Yes. Don't worry, look for it and then you tell me.
For the exercise.
I guess it's number seven, tarea seven, check. Because there is where you have to write questions. But check one thing here. Remember that you have to use the auxiliary in the question, right? And then you use the subject, and then you use the verb in the base form, right? Then you say, did you enjoy the seminar? Did you enjoy the seminar? Mm-hmm. Tell me, Anna.
I found it.
Which one? What number is it?
It's exercise number 2, perdón, number 7, tarea number 7, homework number 7, exercise 2.
Okay. What was the problem? What did you write?
I couldn't understand the meaning of the question. I couldn't organize the sentences.
Okay, remember that when we say meet, meet has two meanings, right? One, when you get together with your friends to go somewhere, you meet your friends. And the other one, when you meet a person for the first time. Yeah, but in this case, can be any or both, right? What did you write in this sentence? Tell me.
I wrote, who does she meet on Saturday?
A ver, session number 7. What were we studying on session number 7? Simple present. Okay, yeah. Who does she?
Meet on Saturday.
Uh-huh. Who does she meet on Saturday? That's okay. Did you get it?
But always say that it's wrong.
Did you begin with capital letter? Uh-huh. Did you begin with capital letter?
Yes, I did.
Did you put Saturday with capital letter?
Yes, I did.
You put a question mark at the end?
Yes, I did. I didn't add an S at the end. Ah.
An S? Oh.
Saturday.
Yeah. Remember that as we are using, it's not the same when a person is checking it and when it's a platform where you put the answers, right? And the answers to be. Even if the apostrophe, your computer puts the apostrophe on the other side, it will take it wrong. So check it. It could be because of the S. Yeah. Because you're doing everything well. It could be just because of that. Mm-hmm. Because of the S, right? Uh-huh. That's why I asked you, did you put capital letter at the beginning? Did you begin the day of the week with capital letter? Did you put the question mark? Because in some other cases, when it is a sentence, if you don't put the period at the end, it will take you wrong too, right? Mm-hmm. So it is very sensible.
Sorry, thank you.
Oh, nice. Okay, now let's go to this one. Uh-huh, because you know, the order is exactly the same if we are using making a question in simple present or simple past. The order is the same. The auxiliary, the subject, and the verb in the base form. Yes? So the order is exactly the same. The only thing is that in the present, you have to be careful if you need to use do or if you need to use does, right? But in the past, as we're talking here, no problem, because we're talking about the past and we know that did is the auxiliary for I, you, we, they, he, she, it. So we do not have to worry about that, right? Okay, what about question number 3? How can you do that question? In the moment, we're thinking simple past questions, right? Hmm? Did?
Did you meet?
Did you meet? Yes, did you meet new people? Huh? What about number four? Number four? Yes.
Did you learn
something? Did you learn something? Okay. And what about this one? Did you never? Uh-huh. Did you network? Did you network in the convention? Did you network in the convention? And what about the last one?
Did you
exchange?
Did you exchange business cards? Very good. Did you exchange business cards? Did you exchange business cards? Nice. I'm going to give you, let's see, a couple of minutes for you to go and ask these questions to your partners. Remember, give your own answers about a seminar that you attended a short time ago. Ready? Ready, ready. Remember, we are on page 24 in your manual, and those are the questions that you're going to ask. Ready, ready? Yes.
Yes, teacher.
Perfect. A bit, we are, how many are we? 2019, I guess, yeah. Okay, one group of four, the others will be groups of three. There you go. Check, try to join.
Hola, teacher. Buenas noches.
Buenas noches.
Teacher, necesito de tu ayuda.
Dígame.
Fíjese de que la tarea número 7 de la unidad 2 no la he podido completar porque dice que es como ordenar la oración, pero ponerle los auxiliares, ¿verdad?
La tarea número 7.
Sí, creo que era de la que estaba hablando con la compañera.
Exacto. Vaya, no tiene que ordenar nada, está en orden. Lo único que tiene que incluirle los auxiliares a la pregunta.
Pero según lo que yo he estado viendo, porque en esas clases no estuve yo, los pongo, pero aún así me tira error.
Vaya, más adelantito vamos a hacer el repasito del Simple Present también. Y vamos a ir a ese detalle, a ver qué es lo que está pasando hoy.
Ok, gracias, teacher.
Bueno, a la orden. Grace y Marina, no las veo que se logren unir al grupo, ¿no les aparece? Veamos. Las voy a mover a otro, tal vez así me las jala.
Ahí voy yo, teacher.
Bye, bye. Vamos a ver, que me ha quedado solito el pobre Ángel. Ah, vaya, ya logró entrar, Yancy. Cheque, eso, very good, Grace. Grace, Grace. La voy a mover quizá a otro, a ver si, si se logra unir. Check.
Y la era un... Hi, teacher.
Hi.
Teacher, ¿es verdad que vamos a work your servant? Donde dice write a la I find like paragraph about the last. No. ¿Ese vamos a hacer?
No, no, ahorita van a hacerse las preguntas de la del ejercicio 6.
Seis.
Ah, estábamos haciendo las preguntas. Ahorita se las va a preguntar al compañero. Ajá. Eso es lo que están haciendo ahorita.
Ok, teacher. Thank you.
Give your own answer, oyen. Ahí mezclen unas respuestas largas y otras respuestas cortas.
Ok. Thank you.
La de poner el... Ahí está la teacher.
Tell me.
Hi, teacher. First, can you allow us to share the screen? And second, teacher, we are going to answer these questions.
Exactly, exactly. The ones that we were making the questions. Now you ask the questions to your partners. Mm-hmm.
Okay. To anybody.
Yeah. Yes.
Okay.
As did you attend to a seminar, Marina? Marina said yes, I did. What did you learn? Did you enjoy the seminar? Uh-huh. Sometimes you attend to a seminar, but you don't enjoy it, right?
Yeah. Okay. Who has attended a seminar recently?
Hi, teacher.
Hello, teacher. Queremos que nos ayude a poder compartir.
Compartir.
Ya le di permiso. Y se me
ah, ok. Parado.
Qué barbaridad. Ya le di permiso.
Por eso es que no hemos avanzado mucho.
Ay, no, qué barbaridad. Sí.
Pero... Qué barbaridad.
Ahí está. Uh-huh.
Page 20.
24.
24. ¿Quién comparte?
Ahí está compartiendo Ana.
Ah, ok.
This is the work.
Yes.
Nice.
Bye.
Thanks, teacher.
Ok.
We are going to answer, ¿verdad? Yes.
Yes.
I did attend.
Seminar.
To attend the seminar.
I attended. I attended. Recuerde que la respuesta ya.
Ah, sí. I attended.
I attended the seminar.
Como el de paso, ¿verdad?
Ajá. Exactly.
Es paso.
You used the past. I attended a seminar
last month. Okay. Is the answer the short answer or the large answer?
You can mix.
Okay.
In some cases you can answer long and in others you can answer short.
Okay.
So did you enjoy the seminar?
Will be
No, we don't.
No. No, I didn't remember, right, to put the auxiliary in past. No,
yes, no, I did. No, no sé, no sé, sí o no.
No, we.
It depends on you. I won't tell you anything because you say, no.
Mix, yes or no?
Yes or no. So did you attend a seminar? You say yes. En la número uno, quítenle por favor el auxiliar.
Oh. Se cayó.
Se cayó.
Se cayó.
Bye.
Vaya. Somebody else.
Bueno.
Vamos a ver si compartimos.
Dale, hagámoslo nosotros. Tal vez regresa.
Tal vez regresa. Ok.
Pero si no se corrió.
Veamos dónde estamos aquí. Creo que estamos, ¿verdad?
Yes. Yes, Charlie.
Se oscureció la pantalla, dice su compañero.
Uy, pero mira.
¿Qué pasa, Charlie?
No, yo no, es que no quiero maximizarlo y no puedo. Porque tengo el menú arriba que no me deja. Ay. Ahí.
Ok, ahí está.
Ahí está. Vale, ahora para escribir el número.
Dale insertar.
Ah, ya. Puede ser.
Cuadro de texto, cuadro de texto. Sí. Ese pequeño, ¿verdad? Va. Escribí algo nada más para quitar esas letras.
Ahí lo voy a poner. Entonces la primera era. Pusimos yes, ¿verdad?
Yes.
Yes, attend. Attended.
Oh. Attended, yes. Sí, ahí no lleva el did ya, yes, ¿verdad, yes, teacher?
Yes. No. Yes, I.
El auxiliar ya no lo lleva porque es respuesta.
Ajá. Pero
el auxiliar solamente es para preguntas, ¿verdad?
Y respuestas negativas.
Y respuestas negativas, ok.
Pero sí le hace falta un sujeto. Yes, I attended.
Ah, sí, yes.
Yes, I attended to a seminar.
I attended to a seminar last month.
¿Qué números son ustedes? Dos.
Tres, si no me equivoco, de hecho.
Ok.
Quiero ver. No, no me fijé. Ahí darle, Charlie, ahí, correcto, y dale, no, la de abajo, dale, esa.
Esta, ¿verdad?
Sí.
Ella me va a dejar. Creo que mejor.
Hoy dale clic derecho a la línea, a la línea. Clic derecho.
Ah, y la quitamos el relleno.
Ajá, correcto. Formato, el último. El último formato. No, no, aquí abajo, dale.
Ah, aquí abajo, sí.
Ahí, formato. Relleno.
Fíjate que está, bueno, yo lo hago de otro modo.
De relleno, quítale sin relleno. Arriba.
Sin relleno.
Ahí está. Y si le quieres quitar la línea, solo dale abajo también, sin línea.
About the topic. I already knew about the topic. Is the teacher here? Oh, okay, teacher, what do you think about our answers?
Mm-hmm.
They are good.
Okay. Did you network? In the convention. Yes, I did.
Yes, I did. We can add I net work with a lot of people. Wait for it, wait for it. I said.
Exchange. Sí,
pero pasado sí es exchange.
Exchange.
Con el con la D. Ajá, con la D al final.
Quizás es error de Google, entonces.
Porque es que así a veces me sale. El traductor no hay que confiarnos porque no traduce bien.
Sí, verdad, es cierto.
Hay que pensar en inglés.
No, vale.
No sé cómo.
A mí cuando me preguntan para responder me quedo en neutro, ni en español ni en inglés, me quedo en blanco.
Bloqueada.
No sé cómo superar eso porque me ha dado en serio, por eso me quedo callada.
Pero... No, y sí, como que de lo... es que yo creo que es como que nos da miedito equivocarnos.
Pero equivocarse no es malo.
Creería yo, no sé.
No, vamos a prueba y error, ¿verdad, Tichi?
Pues sí, ¿quién le ha dicho a ustedes que
equivocarse? No, claro que no.
Equivocarse no es malo.
Cabal.
Se aprende más, ¿verdad, Tichi?
Ahí es donde uno aprende.
Claro, claro.
Sí. Así es.
Lo malo es no equivocarse por no intentarlo.
Cabal.
Pero equivocarse sí que no es malo.
Teacher, okay. Pero ¿cómo puedo superar eso? Porque me quedo así en neutro, como que en blanco prácticamente.
Oyendo,
pero si, le, si entendés.
¿Perdón?
Pero si entendés.
Sí, entiendo, pero ya para comunicarme ya no.
Vaya.
Ahí ya.
Entonces, esta conexión del oído viene de oído-boca. De oído. Entre más escuche usted, más fácil se le va a ir hacer, haciendo hablar. Y cuando esté solita, ¿verdad? Que tenga su ratito libre, se puede grabar en el celular y después se escucha. Y cuando usted se escuche, si no sueno mal, va a ir superando eso. Okay. Esa es una. Y otra, pararse frente al espejo a estar hablando también es un animal.
Ok. Para lo que, voy a intentar.
Para que vaya superando los nervios, que son nervios normales.
Ajá, creo, vea.
Sí, no, sí, es, no es que no sepan, es nervios. ¿Verdad? Entonces, ahí lo primero que tienen que hacer es pensar, ve, y si me equivoco.
¿Cómo que da pena, vea?
Ajá, pero pues no va a ser ni la
única. Creo.
Ni la única, ni la primera.
Ay, no.
La última persona que se equivoca, entonces.
Pues sí, cabal.
Mire, yo de alumna soy bien preguntona. Y por eso es que a mí no me molesta que ustedes me pregunten de todo. Porque yo de alumna, yo pregunto así de todo. Yo así es que.
Okay.
Es que
teacher, cuando usted explica las reglas y todo eso, yo entiendo bien, pero ya no sé. Si usted me pregunta algo verbal, ya me quedo en neutro.
Ajá, sí, es como le digo, es como así poquito a poco de ir venciendo la pena y los nervios.
Uh-huh. Teacher, aprovechando en una de las preguntas, una de las respuestas, en el caso de meet, el pasado de meet sería con una met.
Only one.
Uh-huh. Okay.
Yeah, meet.
Okay. Entonces, seguimos practicando.
Sure. Los
Hello, teacher.
Yeah, finished?
Yes, okay. We finish.
Perfect, perfect. I'm about to call everybody.
Okay.
1 minute.
Okay.
Okay, everybody coming? Let's see. Ya, ¿quién falta? Pues sí, ya todos volvieron, ¿verdad? Coming. Nice. Vaya. Any questions here? A ver, quickly, did you attend to a seminar last month? Yes, I?
Yes, I did.
Do you enjoy the seminar?
Yes, I did.
Did you meet new people?
Several to executives.
Okay. Did you learn something?
No, I didn't, teacher. I already knew about the topic.
You knew about the topic, okay. Did you network in the convention?
Yes, I did.
Did you exchange business cards?
Yes, I did. I exchanged 11 business cards.
Ooh, good. Okay, let's see. I'm taking you. I'm going to stop sharing. But I'm going to call attendance before I move to the next exercise. Vamos a ver, Ana. Ana.
Present.
Angel.
Present.
Benjamin, Ernesto,
present.
Carolina,
present, teacher.
Daniela María,
present, teacher.
Okay, Dani. David Alexander,
present, teacher.
Edwin?
Present.
Okay, Grace Mitchell?
Present, teacher.
Aide de la Paz?
Present, teacher.
Isabel?
Present.
Okay, Jonathan? Jonathan. Juan Antonio. Juan Antonio, no. Karen.
Present, teacher.
Marina.
Present, teacher.
Malene.
Present, teacher.
Present, teacher.
Marina.
Presente, teacher.
A ver, espérenme, que me aparecieron solo. A ver, Karen.
Presente, teacher.
Marina.
Presente, teacher.
Marlene.
Presente, teacher.
Presente,
hacer.
Rosailda. Rosailda. Rosy.
Present.
Teresa de Jesús.
Presente, teacher.
Walter. Judy.
Present, teacher.
Aristides.
Present, teacher.
Brenda. Luis Mauricio. Luis Mauricio. Teresa del Carmen. Teresa. Yancy.
Present.
Okay, nice. Nice. Muy bien. Okay, now check. Here we have an event that is, you will later describe one event that you have attended, right? Check this one. It says, last week I had lunch with Allison, a new member of my network contacts. We saw each other at 3 seminars over the past year, but we really did not know each other very well. I set a goal last year. I would have a one-on-one networking meeting with at least 5 new contacts this year. My 5th contacts meeting was Allison. Our meeting was so rewarding that I want to share the experience. During lunch, Allison mentioned that she was shy by nature. In the past, she said she worried a lot before going to large networking events. I felt surprised because she trusted me that feeling. I got to know more about her, the industry she works in, and about her expectations for the future. I gained more than a new contact. I passed from small talk to smart talk. Underlining here the past, right? The past. Sure. I felt I got. I had lunch. We saw.
She said.
No. She said. She saw. Uh huh. She said. I set a goal. Mm-hmm. Was and was again. Okay, now let's go to the last part. Here is my advice to you. When you attend business events, do not just go and discuss business problems and solutions. Try to get to know at least 3 new people by sharing a one-on-one networking coffee, lunch, or dinner. There are several benefits of this practice. You expand your contacts, improve your networking skills, and you build meaningful connections with people. Okay? They're just talking about networking. If you notice, in the first 2 paragraphs, we are describing the seminar, right, and how she networked another person. And in the last paragraph, in paragraph number 3, she's giving recommendations on what it is to have a connection, right, with other people. Check. When networking with people at meetings, conference, association meetings, or conventions, learn to ask interesting information questions to get the conversation going. Remember, we were talking about that one of these days, right? How to keep the conversation going. And that's why we go from small talk to smart talk, right? You know what is a small talk? You know how to start a small talk. And now if you continue asking like some more interesting questions, you can take that small talk to smart talk, yeah? Now, change the standard, what do you do for a living, for a more creative question to enrich the human exchange. Like what inspires you in your job? What are your daily challenges? Yes, and that way you will see how the other person starts talking about what he or she likes about her job and what makes her or him continue moving, right? Because of course, if you're doing what you like in your job, right, you have the job that you like, you will be passionate and you will start talking about different things related to the topic. Now, look at these questions. You're going to answer about this, right? The description of this seminar here. You have, are these sentences true or are they false? I'm going to give you a couple of minutes for you to answer those questions related to, okay? What page are you in? Let me tell you that here we are on page 26, yeah? Go to page 26 in your manual. Read again if necessary and then answer the questions. True or false? True or false? Okay, are you ready? Allison and Miss Tate saw each other for the first time last week. Is that true or false?
False. They know very well. They know each other very well.
They had lunch, right, the previous week, but they saw each other at seminars before, so yes. Aristides says they know each other very well now. Okay, Miss Tate set a networking goal for this year.
True.
True. Allison confessed she hated networking events. She hated networking events?
False.
False, right? She didn't hate them. She was nervous, right? About the networking events. Miss Tate and Allison passed from small talk to smart talk during lunch.
True.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Miss Tate mentioned three benefits of one-on-one networking meetings. True or false?
True.
Yes.
It's true. Yes.
It's true.
Those several benefits.
Only one benefit. Vamos a ver. How many?
Expand your contacts, improve your networking skills, and you build meaningful connections with people in the industry.
Uh-huh. It's not only one, right? So yes, that's false. That's false because she doesn't mention. But it says she mentioned three benefits. Let's see how many.
There are.
You have to get to know at least three new people. Well, when you attend
several benefits.
Try to get to know at least one, at least three new people by sharing a one-on-one networking coffee. That's one. There are several benefits for this practice. Well, these are two. You and your contacts. One. You expand your benefit, your contacts, you improve your networking skills, and you build meaningful connections with people. I could say it's true because she shares three, right? One, you expand your contacts. Two, you improve your networking skills. And three, you build meaningful connections with people in the industry. Right? Okay, so it is true, right? Because she mentioned three benefits. Okay, questions over there? No questions. No?
No questions, teacher.
Perfect. Okay, now we're going to do this exercise. Let's see. Some of them are affirmative, some others are negative, and some others are questions. I'm going to share them with you. Here. And I'm going to send you to work. Se los pongo en el chat de Teams.
Yes, in chat.
Okay, good.
We're gonna work
on you.
And I'm going to share it in the
chair. Are we going to work in pairs or in a team?
You're going to work in teams.
Okay.
Let me share it.
The same team, teacher.
Yes. No. Okay. No. I'm going to change you. Ahí está. Se me había escondido la tijera. Vaya. Ahí está. I'm going to stop sharing here. Que si no, Teams me regaña que comparto y que se ve en WhatsApp. Ahí está. Zoom me regaña, me dice, estás compartiendo tu WhatsApp. No. Bye, there you go. I'm going to remake the groups so you work with different people and I'm going to add one more group. Yeah, perfect. Ahí está. Quedan dos parejas y los demás en tríos. There you go. Try to join. Try to join. Nice. A ver allí, Chancy, Chequen, Ángel. Nice. Perfect.
Okay, ahorita comparto. Okay.
Alguien se escribió.
¿Hola?
Ah, Jonathan.
Ah, ahí está Jonathan. ¿Estás ahí, Jonathan?
No, tiene el micrófono apagado. Teacher.
¿A mí?
The microphone. How do you say microphone? Micrófono apagado. Turn off.
The Microsoft off. Maybe.
The thing is that I guess Jonathan is still working.
So okay.
Only listening. Yeah, he's still working.
Okay. Yeah. Let's see. Last year's the verse into the correct form.
Okay. Sería last year. The correct from simple past.
Spend.
One moment, please. Spend. Is correct?
Spend it.
Spent.
The next, David Wright.
Spent. David. ¿Sí? Sería, will be S-P-E-N-T. Raise D-E-D. Ajá. También D, erase D.
Uh-huh.
And now letter T. It's correct, teacher.
Learned. Spent. Went. Spent. Spent. S-P-E-N-T. Spent.
It is simple pass.
It great.
El verbo to be.
Ah, tercera persona, ¿verdad?
Ajá, uh-huh. It.
It.
It. Have.
No, be, the past verb be is. Yes, was.
It was.
It was great.
Uh-huh.
It
was.
The other number three.
The travel.
Ricardo is here in our groups, but in the second model. But she and Rosa and Carolina, this is another group.
Yes. Reina.
Quita esta. Visited, learner.
It's.
¿De qué es?
Negative, right?
Yes. Past.
¿Cuál es el auxiliar que usamos para todos los demás verbos?
Do
in present y en past
didn't Didn't rain a lot.
Yes, didn't rain. Didn't rain a lot. Good. Checking la número uno.
Last year I spent
is irregular.
Spent con
la de la cambia a ti. Spent.
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 Yeah, spent.
Okay, thank you. Okay, teacher, I a little bit confused. I do not wait a lot. But it's simple past.
Por eso el auxiliar es el que está en pasado y el verbo ya no. ¿Se acuerda que decíamos que la estructura es el auxiliar didn't? En negative y después el verbo en forma base o el auxiliar al principio, el sujeto y el verbo en forma base para la pregunta.
For example, if I say, yo no comí, I didn't eat.
Exactly.
Always, always. Oh, for example, no dormí, I didn't sleep.
I didn't sleep.
Y si the next, y si we have the auxiliar.
Ajá. Y si lo va a hacer pregunta, did you eat? Did you sleep? El auxiliar es sujeto y el verbo en forma base. El único momento en el que usted va a poner el verbo en pasado es en las afirmativas, porque ahí no ocupa auxiliar. Pero en las, negativas sí preguntas como ocupa auxiliar, el auxiliar es el que se ve en pasado. Y el verbo queda en forma base.
For example, the first one, it supposed it was it negative form. Last year, I didn't spend my holiday in Ireland.
Exactly. If it were negative, it would be I didn't spend. I didn't spend.
Estos libros tratan de uno solo de cosas de.
Some beautiful rain.
Reportaba cosas que tenían que ver con el momento.
With beautiful rainbows.
Oh, some beautiful rainbows.
The last one.
Y Yuri no está por allí.
Sí, teacher, aquí estoy poniendo atención.
Ay, no, colabore, colabore.
Ajá, no he estado.
So ready to hear it.
Where?
Then,
do you? Where did you?
Did you? Exactly.
Spend? Where? Did you spend your last?
Ajá. Where did you spend? Very good.
Con T.
No, con D.
Ah, no.
D en pasado. Ajá, con D en pasado. Con D.
Sí, sí, you spend. Sí, sí, tiene razón.
Estamos muy bien, chicos. Perfect.
Teacher.
Tell me.
Cuando dicen forma pasada es cuando se refiere forma base.
No, este es presente.
En el presente.
Que la forma base es el verbo así como usted dice, go, play, swim. Esa es la forma base. Y ya cuando lo pone en pasado es went, spent, swam. ¿Se acuerdan la listita de verbos que les compartí la vez pasada? El primero que aparece que está en presente es la forma base. La forma base es que usted no lo ha conjugado con nada, ni para ser tercera persona, ni nada. Que solamente tiene go, play, swim, eat, go, read. Está en presente.
¿Ya necesito ejercicio?
Pero ya cuando usted lo empieza a conjugar, she goes, she plays, she swims, she dances. ¿Ya?
Ok.
Ya han pasado, she went, she swam, she spent, she ate. Ya igual, ¿verdad? Ya cambia más todavía.
Ok.
Los dejo un ratito.
La traveler con visited.
Sí.
La cuarta usually go el queen.
Sí. Hi, teacher.
Hi.
¿Qué otra? Hi.
Teacher, fíjese de que...
Pero tenemos una consulta, que en esto sí tenemos algo de duda. Es la 9, que dice, where spend you your last holiday? Nosotras la hemos puesto, where did you spend? Con el verbo en forma base porque lleva el auxiliar. Your last holiday. Está correcta.
Perfecto.
Ay, muy bien, Karen. No andamos tan perdidas.
Ah, vaya. Porque nos olvida.
Habíamos hecho una tortada, habíamos hecho.
Ay, no es feo.
En serio, teacher, estábamos poniendo.
Habíamos puesto, where are you spent?
Ay, pero se acordaron, mire, encontraron el campo solito, muy bien.
Sí, sí.
Excelente. Ya terminamos. Ah,
esta fue como la que más nos costó.
Sí, sí, ya terminamos.
Sí, estuvo.
Excelente, me las llevó. Ready again. Let's see. Pasha, vamos a ver. Last year I
spent.
I spent. My holiday in Ireland. It.
Was great.
Was great. I
traveled.
I traveled. This is another type of event, meeting. No es un seminar, pero es otro tipo de event, right? I traveled around by car with two friends and we
We visited
lots of interesting places. In the evening, we usually
We were lucky, very lucky. We were.
Los dos son aceptables. T en vez de ID, T. What about number six? We
were
were.
Here. We were very lucky. It
didn't rain.
Did it rain?
We
saw.
Saw.
Saw some beautiful rainbows. And number nine, we.
Where did you spend?
Where did you spend?
Where did you? Este estaba tricky, le tiraste you para allá. Pero estaba tricky, right? Where did you spend? Where did you spend your last one? Where did you spend your last one? Questions? No questions.
Yes, question. Yes, teacher, I have a question.
Mm-hmm.
But it is not from the simple past. It's something I want to know. How do you say tacaña in English?
Stingy. Stingy.
Stingy.
Stingy.
Can you write it down, please?
Yes.
Or can you spell it?
S okay. I-M. G-Y. Stingy.
Stingy. And teacher, have you ever heard that people from Ouachapon are stingy?
Teacher, you say don't know.
No, I have heard it. I have heard it. But I said, but I am not sure if that is true.
Okay.
The question is for it because Aristides, tell me.
You know, my aunt lives in Ouachapon.
Yes.
She's not a stingy, but she's not from Ouachapon. Así que no sé.
No, I tell to Aristides, the people of Ouachapon is no stingy.
I saw stingy.
No.
Are you sure?
Yes. How do you say aborrativa?
Huh?
How do you say aborrativa?
Oh. They are good savers.
Yes.
Sure.
No, thank you.
Okay. Thanks, teacher.
Okay. Now, we are going to move to another tense that we were talking about this unit, right? And it's the simple present. Teníamos por allí un debate sobre el tú y el tú y todo eso. Recuerden. Es de un polo. Vaya, el auxiliar para el presente es do. Este es present. Present. Puede ser do o das. Depende de la persona que esté usando. ¿Sí? So you say, what do? Si se fija aquí mi verbo do y mi auxiliar do. What do you do? Esta es una de las preguntas que más problema dan, porque cuando usamos Yuri, la voy a callar. Es que hoy no sé por qué se oye como medio mal Apolo. Ya sé, como ¿verdad? No sé por qué. Vaya, chequen. Tenemos do como auxiliar y do como verbo. Entonces, ¿qué sucede cuando usted pregunta what do you do? Y fíjense que es donde se da así como que más duda el decir what you do. Es auxiliar, ¿verdad? No importa si usted está usando el verbo do, pero ya sabe que do significa hacer, ¿verdad? El verbo do es hacer. pero igual siempre tiene que tomarse auxiliar. Igual que el verbo supervise le ponemos auxiliar, ¿verdad? O manage le ponemos auxiliar. Entonces, igual, este verbo es do y el auxiliar es do. What department do you supervise? Auxiliary, subject, verb. Por allí a un grupo le decía yo, el orden a seguir es el mismo. La diferencia que con el presente usamos do o does y con el pasado usamos did. ¿Verdad? Pero de ahí es el mismo orden a seguir cuando nosotros hacemos la pregunta. Que siempre necesitamos el auxiliary. Check this one. Where does your company manufacture? Where does your company manufacture? What unit do you oversee? Y va a depender, este do o does, va a depender del sujeto. Your company is it. Por lo tanto, yo ocupo does. Pero you, con you, yo ocupo do. ¿Verdad? Who do you report to? Who do you report to? I report to my supervisor, right? I report to the manager. Any question here? No question. Vamos a ver. Remember to ask information questions in the simple present. Begin with a double H phrase or a double H word. ¿Con qué empezamos? ¿Con double H phrase o double H word? It's a double H word. Double H word. Puede ser una double H phrase cuando usted dice how many. How many. Eso se convierte en phrase porque ya van dos palabras. ¿Sí? What branch. Eso ya no es un double H word, es double H phrase. How much, how big, what size. Porque se va a convertir en parte de la frase. Entonces ya cuando no tiene solamente el what, when, where, esos son word, double H word. Pero si ya va con what unit, por ejemplo, la number five, what branch, what department, eso ya es double H phrase, porque lleva dos palabras. Más de dos palabras, phrase, una word, ¿ya? A ver, followed by, ¿qué sigue a la double H word?
For do double that. Phrase. Do or
auxiliary, that. Exactly, the auxiliary, right? Can be do, can be does. And then, después del auxiliary, ¿qué sigue?
The subject.
El subject, exactly. Y después del subject, ¿qué sigue después del subject?
It's verb.
El verbo en forma base.
Base form.
Yes, that's the base form of the verb. Yeah, the base form of the verb. Y si se fija, ahí le comentaba yo a un grupo sobre la forma base del verbo, que está aquí el verbo que no está conjugado. ¿Sí? Ya cuando usted lo empieza a conjugar, que le empieza a poner, por ejemplo, en el caso de las terceras personas, que le pone S o S, ya ese verbo conjugado ya no es verbo en forma base. Pero cuando estamos haciendo una pregunta, independientemente de si es con tercera persona, yo voy a poner el verbo en forma base, porque la S que necesito ya va en el auxiliar. ¿Sí? Aquí va ya la S. Where do you live? Where does your sister live? Si se fija, live igual en las dos. Where do you work? Where does Aristides work? ¿Verdad? No le voy a poner works porque estoy hablando de tercera persona. Porque el auxiliar es el que va a sufrir el cambio. En vez de decir, where do you work? Where does he work? Entonces, es este auxiliar el que lleva el cambio.
Teacher.
Lleva la S. Tell me, Ana.
According to your explanation, what happened about the number, the example number 2, 3, and 5? I don't understand.
Estos son word phrase, word double H phrase. Lo que les decía, double H phrase es la double H word más otra palabra. Porque ya cuando lleva dos palabras se convierte en phrase. Ya no es una palabra, ya es una frase. Por ejemplo, si usted dice what size, how big, how tall, how long. Todas esas son double H phrases. Entonces, por eso es que le dice que empieza con una double H phrase or double H word. ¿Verdad? Dependiendo de qué es lo que usted está preguntando. Entonces, cuando usted dice what department, what branch, what unit, son double H phrases, porque llevan dos palabras. ¿Ya? Any other question? Any other question? No. Vaya, vámonos a los exercises. A ver, what department does Marta manage? Marta, si se fijan, what, tenemos un double H phrase, el auxiliar, mi subject y el verbo en forma base. ¿Sí? Según lo que nos mostraba la diapositiva anterior. Ahora, cuando respondemos, si se fijan, aquí sí ya conjugamos el verbo. Y ya le ponemos S. Marta manages the sales department. ¿Yes? A ver, hagamos la pregunta número 2.
What department do you supervise?
What department? Esperen, vámonos al libro mejor para escribir más adelante. Let's see, go to page, ya les digo qué página es. 22. Okay. Nice. A ver, what department? Do you supervise? What department do you supervise? Yes, uy, se me lo quedó esto. No sé. Ahí está. A ver, number 3.
What? Branch does Claudio oversee?
Branch does Claudio
oversee.
Ya no es, ¿verdad? What branch does Claudio oversee? Very good. What about the number 4? The assemblers report to the supervisor. What is the double H word that we need here?
Who?
Who?
Who? Who does?
Who the assembler?
Does the assembler.
Do does?
Do.
¿Por qué do y no does?
Plural.
Exactly.
There are many assemblers.
Ajá, it's not only one, right? Vamos a hacer esta double H mayúscula, ajá. Who do the assemblers?
Report to.
Report to. Who do the assemblers report to? They report to the supervisor. A ver, the manufacturer in the Santa Ana plant. We manufacture. What double H word do we need?
Where
do you, okay, where do you
manufacture?
Where do you manufacture? We manufacture in the Santa Excellent. And the last one, Douglas trains the new staff. What double H word do you need here?
What does Douglas do?
Que aquí anda una personita traviesa. Bye. What does Douglas do? What does Douglas do? He trains the English. Good. Any questions over there?
Yes, teacher. In number three, why does?
¿Por qué das? ¿Por qué usamos el auxiliar das?
Ah, third person.
Ah, porque es third person, porque es Claudio, right?
Mm-hmm. Teacher, I have a question.
Okay.
I don't know, it is just an idea. What if I, the question number five, I don't know if it could be which plant do you manufacture?
In.
In.
Yeah, sure.
Can I?
Yeah.
Okay.
Which plant do you manufacture in? Yeah, sure.
Okay.
Cuando usa which, tiene que usar la preposición. Esta que está aquí. Ocupa where, no. Pero si quiere utilizar.
Okay.
But yes, it's possible.
Thanks.
Carlos, no sé si le quedó clara esta pregunta número 3.
Yes.
Okay.
I have another question. In number 6.
Yeah.
Only what will be with who?
Who? Pero lo malo es que como le dan el verbo, fíjese. Porque si no le dieran el verbo, perfectamente podría, si el verbo que le dieran sería fuera train, usted podría decir who trains the new staff. Who trains the new staff? Douglas trains the new staff. Porque sí se puede, ¿verdad? Sí se puede, pero allí depende de el verbo y qué es lo que está preguntando. Pero por la pregunta que tiene, claro que sí puede usar.
Thanks.
Okay. Any other questions there? No questions. Vámonos pues al vocabulary allá. Allá. That's page 20. Aquí. Este es page 27. Page 27.
Salud, porque la gata te dará alergia.
Ay, de. A ver, vamos a ver. Esta es la página que vamos a ver. Check. What you're going to do here is find 10 words from the word below, or from the box below in the word search. Aquí tenemos industry, staff, networking, branch, guests, headquarters, small talk, manufacturer, personnel, and expertise. ¿Sí? Vamos a ver. Industry.
Está en la lista de abajo.
Está.
Yes.
Industry.
Industry, where is industry?
Tercera columna de mi derecha en la izquierda.
Tengo un problema con eso.
Tercera columna.
Tell me izquierda, derecha en español.
Después, después de la P.
No, hacia abajo. Isabel.
En la primera línea, personal.
Isabel, tengo un problema con izquierda y derecha en español. Si me dicen inglés, le sigo. Pero si me dicen español, ahí sí me tengo ese. A ver.
Left or right.
Left or right. Ajá. Sí, la teacher, para que le diga en inglés, no es.
My right. My right.
Vaya Luis Mauricio, métase allí y marque.
My right.
Por ahí andaba Luis Mauricio, marque industria. Vamos a ver. Oh, branch. Okay. Vaya Isabel, usted
primera línea. En la primera línea está personal.
Okay. Industry, pero recto. Recto. Recto, como decía nuestro amigo Cantinfla, recto. A ver, muy bien, industry. Another.
Ya encontré manufacturer.
Where is my... Oh, yes. A ver, dígame, ya lo vi.
Ya vio.
Right
here.
So,
yeah.
Personal.
Yeah,
baño. Personal.
Barbaridad. Mire.
Ahí está.
A ver.
Teacher, le cuento que me encantan las sopas de letra. Y me compré un librito de sopa de letra, pero en inglés.
Hey,
me encanta. Y cuando no se la sintaba la palabra, se lo pongo a la par.
¿Y sabe qué?
Todo manchado lo tengo.
That's nice. Y es...
Personal teacher.
Es un excelente ejercicio para la mente y para la rapidez mental. Es que, a ver, what is personal?
The first.
What is this? Okay, yes. Personal, good, Jancy. ¿Qué dice aquí? Y aquí, ¿qué
pasa? I have working, teacher.
Working.
Yes. Es small talk, es la parte de industry.
Ajá, exactly. Aquí está network.
Headquarter, teacher.
Headquarter. What is headquarter?
Small talk.
Okay.
Small talk es la parte de industry.
Small talk. Vamos a ver. Small talk.
No pude escribir bien.
Oh,
teacher.
De arriba para abajo.
Expertise, también teacher. Expertise.
Ajá.
expertise.
Expertise.
Over staff.
Staff.
Down, down.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Ya lo marcaron. Expertise. Okay, vaya, ya marcamos industry, staff, headquarters, small talk, networking, ¿verdad? Sí.
Yes.
Manufacture, yeah.
Manufacture.
Branch.
Yes.
Branch. Personnel, yeah.
Yes.
Guest.
Yes.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Okay.
Oh, el que yo preguntaba.
I mark. Sorry.
Que yo preguntaba, ¿y qué es lo que ha marcado aquí? Puedo leer al revés, fíjese, pero no, yes. No había cachado. Oh, we found all. Yeah?
Yes.
We found all of them. Nice. Do you have any questions here about vocabulary? Questions. Mm-hmm. Any questions?
No, teacher, no questions.
No questions. Easy. A piece of cake.
Yes.
Yeah. It's a piece of cake. Vaya. ¿Qué vamos a hacer hoy con las últimas palabras que tenemos en el listo? A cake. Vamos a hacer acá. Qué chistoso, mira. Vamos a trabajar con estas palabras. You're going to write questions in the simple present. Acá. ¿Sí? Por ejemplo, supervisors. No importa que no vayan en orden, ocupen las que quieran primero. Who supervises? Who supervises? Who supervises you? Tengo problema para esto. Who supervises you? Eso es quien lo supervisa a usted. Who supervises you? Voy a borrar porque se ve bien chistoso. A ver. Who supervises you? A ver, right, remember here we're using only the simple present in this part. Only the simple present. The typewriter. Who supervises? O usted puede preguntar también, who do you supervise? Yeah? Who supervises you or who do you supervise? Do you oversee any branch? Ahí estuvo, ya le di copia. Now you write the others. Okay? Do you supervise any branch? Or do you oversee any branch? Mm-hmm. Supervise any branch? Or do you oversee any branch? Yeah. Yo voy a pasar lista mientras ustedes terminan ahí y después me cuentan. Ok. Allá vamos a ver. Okay, vamos a ver. Tell me present. Ana.
Present.
Okay. Angel.
Present.
Benjamin. Carlos Ernesto.
Present. Okay.
Carolina. Carolina.
Present teacher.
Daniela.
Present teacher.
Okay. David.
Present teacher.
Edwin Orlando.
Present.
Grace.
Present teacher.
Aide de la Paz.
Present teacher.
Isabel Hernandez. Isabel.
Present.
Jonathan.
Present teacher.
Juan. Juan Antonio. Karen.
Present teacher.
Marina.
Present teacher. Present teacher.
Teresa de Jesús. Teresa de Jesús. Se nos perdió Teresa. Walter. Y Alexandra. Yuri. Yuri. Ahí andaba Yuri.
Present teacher, es que no había activado el micrófono y más que me estaba quedando sin carga justo ya cuando iba a pasar lista también.
Ay no, yo creí que me iba a decir más que ya me estaba quedando dormida.
No, me cambié de donde estaba porque ya no tengo carga y aquí estoy conectada.
Ah, vaya, vaya, qué bueno, es que ya falta poquito. Que la molesta la teacher, ¿verdad? ¡Qué barbaridad! Aristides.
Present teacher.
Okay. Brenda. David Mauricio.
Present teacher.
Ok, se me había perdido.
Yes.
Lo vi, después ya no lo vi, y después allá lo vi después.
Me falló el inter y me sacó varias veces y no conectaba, hasta que reinicié el teléfono. Pero aquí andamos de nuevo.
Bien, bien. Teresa de Jesús, Teresa del Carmen. Teresa, ¿verdad?
Present.
Ahí estamos. Muy bien, chicos. Excelente. A ver, rapidito. Tell me, what did you ask here? Tell me a question with oversee.
No sé si está correcto, pero who oversee network?
Okay, who oversees the network? Okay. Okay. Si hubiera un net, podría haber un networking department, ¿verdad? Podría ser. Ok, manufacturer. Who wants to use manufacturer? Where?
Teacher, I did the question I told you before. Which plant do you manufacture in?
Which plant do you manufacture in? Good. Be in charge. Be in charge. What are you in charge of doing? Yeah. Who is in charge of of the accounting department, for example. ¿Sí? Who is in charge of the accounting department? What about network? Network. Network. Oh, no, 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 only one. A ver, Luis. Just one with network. Para que nos vayamos, la última. No nos vamos. Ajá. The last one. Network.
Okay. Who companies is for your network?
Which companies are in your network? Okay. Vamos a ver quién se queda conmigo ahora. Que no me acuerdo. Vamos a ver. No me acuerdo. ¿Se acuerdan ustedes? A ver.
No, teacher.
Es 15 de noviembre. Aide. Aide le toca. No se había quedado Aide todavía, ¿no? ¿Verdad? Ah, pues Aide le toca. ¿Puede quedarse conmigo?
¿Y en la semana quién le toca, teacher?
Ya le digo. Mañana, sí, ¿verdad? Para que sí, así ustedes. Mañana, martes 16, lunes 15 y mañana lunes 16. No, mentira. Martes 16, Isabel. Miércoles 17, Jonathan. Jueves 18, Juan Antonio. Viernes 19, Karin. Okay. Solo un comercial antes de que se vaya. Recuerden que he hecho mañana tempranito. Unidad 2 que incluye midterm exam. ¿Sí? Yancy, no sé si le quedó claro lo que me había preguntado sobre las preguntas en afirmativo.
No.
No. Vaya. No. Vaya, vamos a ver. Antes de que nos vayamos. Voy a agregar una página aquí. Vaya, usted me preguntaba sobre el auxiliar, ¿verdad? En la pregunta.
Sí.
Cuando nosotros decimos, what do you study? What do you study? Mi auxiliar, y lo voy a poner de otro color. A ver, mouse, ¿dónde te metes? Bueno, vamos a escribir las oraciones primero y después que se me aloca. Ok, what do you study? Si estamos usando you, ¿verdad? Siempre, siempre vamos a tomar el auxiliar dependiendo del sujeto. What do you study? Where do you live? ¿Verdad? Siempre la double-edged word, el auxiliar y el sujeto. Si mi sujeto es she, where does she work? Where does she work? Ahí el auxiliar va a cambiar porque estoy usando la tercera persona.
Okay. ¿Sí?
Y el verbo siempre va a ir en forma básica. El verbo siempre, siempre va a ir en forma base. Siempre. No importa si usted está hablando de tercera persona o no, porque lo que va a cambiar es el auxiliar. ¿Sí?
Entonces, Michelle, en este caso, que la pregunta es, what is machine do? El machine es la base, lo que me ha subrayado con azul.
Este es el verbo.
El verbo.
Este es el verbo. Repítame la pregunta. What does?
What is machine do?
Tendría que ser what does. Que su auxiliar va a ser das.
No, o sea, la número una así está descrita. What this machine pleca do?
Es que le pone what, la pleca, this machine do. Sí, ¿verdad? Entonces usted va a decir, what? Aquí en esta parte entre esto, porque este es su sujeto. Como this machine es como que usted diga it. Pues vamos a usar el auxiliar das.
Das.
Das, this machine. Y el verbo que nos queda igual, no va a cambiar. Porque no, en forma base. Entonces queda igual. Lo que usted tiene que agregar es el auxiliar, porque
el auxiliar que es el das.
Ajá, exacto. Porque el auxiliar no se lo dan. La dejan a usted para que escoja si va a ocupar dudas.
Pero fíjese que lo intenté hacer así, lo envié y siempre me tiraba los chequecitos en rojo.
Habría que ver si no está poniendo letras mayúsculas donde debe. Si no,
no, solo la que aparece al inicio, que esa siempre va en mayúscula, que sería la del what. Pero los demás sí, hasta inclusive el signo de interrogación lo he puesto, pero siempre me lo tira en error.
Claro. Mándeme al WhatsApp una foto de cómo la está poniendo para ver qué es lo que pasa.
Yo se lo comparto, teacher. Gracias.
Perfecto. Ok, bueno, have a nice day. See you tomorrow.
Bye bye. Bye bye.
Bye bye. Good night, teacher.
Bye bye.
Good night, teacher.
Good night, teacher.
Bye bye. Good night. It's a Friday. Se me fue. Hi, Jonathan. Hi, Jonathan.